this is now, I think, it's probably the biggest regeneration project in the city region as we go forward. And it just proves that we did the right thing and we're doing the right thing with the combined authority and bringing those powers from Westminster down into our area.
As a committed Liverpoolian, I think Everton might have something to say about which is the biggest regeneration project. But outside of that, certainly what you're proposing in Southport is literally transformational for that area, but for much further, because as was just alluded to, everyone's got great memories of going to Southport. It just lost its way a little bit, didn't it? And now this is going to give it its mojo back, and I think it's perhaps the catalyst for wider regeneration in that area. So it's great news for everyone. Can we agree the recommendations on page 119? This is under SIF funded education support programme, and it's to provide £5 million from SIF to support that education support programme in 5 of the most deprived communities throughout the city region. And the item contains an exempt appendix again, so we know the script here. If we do want to discuss the content, the appendix, the monitoring officer will guide us through that process. But Councillor Paul is going to take us through this. He's the Deputy Portfolio Holder, and will introduce the report in the absence of Mayor Anderson. Then, Aileen, if you need to add anything, please feel free to do so.
Thank you. The Education Support Programme is a pioneering £5 million plan to improve life chances in some of the city region's most deprived areas, particularly in the education outcomes for children and young people. Members are asked to approve £5 million funding to support the rollout of the Cradle to Career Change Programme to a further 5 areas across the Liverpool City region, following its success in North Birkenhead. Cradle to Career is a programme delivered in partnership with Wirral Council, instigated and funded by the Steve Morgan Foundation and Shine, and managed nationally by national charity Right to Succeed. In North Birkenhead, Cradle to Career has had significant impacts in its first 2 years of delivery, linked to its co-designed interventions centred on education, community, families and services. It has brought together residents, local services, professionals and community leaders to support children and young people in one of the most deprived areas of the Liverpool City region. The Steve Morgan Foundation and Shine are committed to the community of North Birkenhead in the long term and to extending the impact of this pioneering work across the Liverpool City region. The rollout of the programme will see the place-based cradle to career approach introduced in 5 of the city region's areas most in need, with a wide range of different organisations and agencies working closely with the communities to improve outcomes for children and young people, managed by Right to Succeed. Finally, the Combined Authority funded pre-development work in Northwood, Knowsley and Horton Lee, which has been completed and delivery arrangements are being finalised. Right to Succeed anticipate that pre-development work will start in Sefton and St Helens early 2023 and in Liverpool later in 2023.
Yeah, it's very exciting, given young people best start their life. I remember that used to be a very apposite way in which the previous government approached things. Short start? Anyone? Children's centres? Yeah, it's the right thing to do. Aileen, anything that you need to add?
Nothing further, yeah, thanks, mate.
Okay, so with that said, can we agree the recommendations on page 271, please? 14 is more SIF. It's called Capital for Social Good, and it's a report that set out proposals to loan £800,000 from the SIF fund to the social enterprise called Juno to help to develop a self-sustaining, not-for-profit model for providing residential children's homes. And the item again has an exempt appendix, and we know what the next bit is, so I won't go into it, but Councillor Williamson, take us through the report, and then I'll hand over to the gate to Aileen if she's got anything to add.
Secretary Mayor, I'm really pleased to present this today. I'm sure that my fellow members here will be all too aware that providing high quality accommodation and support for vulnerable children in care is very challenging. All too often we cannot place children close to their homes. As the report says, the market for children's homes places is broken, with some private providers charging excessive profits. These are providers, by the way, that don't care about our kids, they just care about making money, and they're rinsing local councils as they do it. This report provides us with an opportunity to start to break this cycle. Capacity Community Interest Company is proposing to set up a new venture called Juno, which will develop and manage new children's homes across the city region on a not-for-profit basis. My own authority in Wirral has committed to supporting this venture, as have a number of philanthropic individuals and organisations. This report proposes providing a loan of £800,000 to Juno to support the development of this venture and the creation of the first four homes. While there is inevitably risk of any new organisation, there is a clear risk of doing nothing. I would therefore like to note my support to the recommendations, and I'm really, really pleased about this one. We need to absolutely support this and set about changing the horrendously broken market that we're currently in at the minute. Thank you.
Thanks, Mayor. As Councillor Williams said, this is a really challenging service delivery area for local authorities. This proposal is offering a different model, different business model, which focuses on the quality of care for children. And we're really pleased to be working in partnership with Capacity CIC on this project. Thanks, Mayor.
Yeah, and for me, it demonstrates the maturity of this organisation now that we can bring these sort of things forward, and got huge support from each of our six local authorities. If there are no other questions or comments, now can we do the recommendations on 319, please? Just while we're going on to the next one, it's a remiss of me not to welcome you, Angela, to your first Command Authority meeting. Apologies for that. You're very welcome. We're on to item 15, which is a report that provides an update with the former Littlewood building redevelopment, and we're seeking agreement to some changes to the project, which was first came to the Command Authority for approval in June 2021, and again, there's an exempt appendices, but we leave all that because we know what happens if we want to discuss that. But again, I fall to the Councillor Williamson to take us through the report, and then for Dr. Amy Jones, if we need any further information, over to you.
Me again, thank you, Mayor. This paper provides an update on the redevelopment of the former Littlewood building, as you've just said. As members will be aware, the Combined Authority has looked for a number of years to support the redevelopment of this iconic building as a hub for film and education. This has proved difficult to progress due to complex land ownership issues, the condition of the building following the fire in 2018, and the number of different parties involved. In order to support the film industry, we have already aided Liverpool City Council's investment in film studio space, the depot, on adjacent land. This is proving highly successful, demonstrating the potential that film studios could have. Liverpool John Moores University have now informed us that they are unable to commit to taking space in the redeveloped building as an anchor tenant. Whilst this is disappointing, redevelopment of the building still offers an enormous opportunity for the creation of a film hub with the employment that this will bring to the region. This report therefore recommends that we proceed with the first phase of the project, which will stabilise the existing building and develop the detailed designs to allow for a future full development to proceed. But as set out in the report, we need to do this in a considered way, and another decision of the Combined Authority will be required before providing any further funding. Thank you.
Hayley?
Nothing further, thanks, Mayor.
I will, just to thank officers really for their perspicacity and patience over this period. It's just one of those difficult projects, but I think somebody said before, there seems to be light at the end of the tunnel, fingers crossed, so this could be huge if we did bring this one off, but it's due to the hard work by others on this that we've got to this stage. So if we can agree the recommendations set out, they're on page 339 of the report.
Mm-hmm.
16 is about growing business visits, and it's a report that seeks £1.4 million to support the visitor economy. We know how important that is at the moment, don't we? So, Councillor Williamson, because it's SIF, they'll hand it to you, but because it's visitor economy, we'll also include Councillor Walton.
Thank you, Metro Mayor. Really, really relevant given our news about Eurovision. Exciting. So this paper seeks approval for £1.42 million for the second phase of the Liverpool City Region Growing Business Events programme to be delivered between 2023 and 2028. Building on the success of the Phase 1 programme, which has supported 30 conferences since 2019 and generated more than £13 million for the economy. Under the proposal, a £4.37 million fund will be created, with the combined authority contributing £1.42 million towards attracting major events. The remainder will come from private sources. The money will be used to ensure Liverpool remains competitive in attracting lucrative business visitors by offering funding support to national and international conferences, as well as major sporting events at ACC Liverpool, and of course now major music events as well. The authority will support the five-year project whilst it transitions to a commercially self-sustaining model funded from private sources. Hoteliers and service accommodation owners in Liverpool will start balloting on October the 28th over creating an accommodation business improvement district that will provide the private sector funds for the initiative. Our visitor economy is vital to our region's prosperity, and business visitors and conferences are a crucial part of that sector. If approved, this investment will enable us to compete with major cities, attracting high-profile conferences, sporting events, as well as showcasing the city region's strengths to potential investors. And just before I finish, Mr. Mayor, I'd just like to thank you for intervening as well in the issue around hugely inflated accommodation prices. What we don't want is to have to tarnish the event. So thank you.
Well, we don't. Councillor Wolfe.
Thank you, Metro Mayor. Just a brief comment from myself as the portfolio lead for tourism for the combined authority. We are working hard to ensure the Liverpool City Region's visitor economy recovers strongly from the pandemic. Last year, you will recall, we approved a £1.5 million destination marketing fund to attract visitors back to the city region, which I think it has been successful. Of course, ensuring the Liverpool City Region remains competitive in attracting major conferences and events, which you've referred to yourself today, is vital, which of course Councillor Williamson has said, if we are to increase the number of business visitors who occupy hotel rooms during weekdays. These events also allow us to showcase the city region's strengths to potential investors, which is massively important. So actually, I really welcome this fund. I think it is absolutely superb that actually we can do these sorts of things. So I'm fully supportive of this recommendation.
Thanks, Councillor Walker. Any questions for anyone on this issue? If not, the recommendations are set out on page 251. Can they be agreed? 17 is a report that details the award of £525,000 of funding secured by the City Region Growth Company received from the Careers and Enterprise Company, and the funding will allow the Growth Company to continue to deliver the excellent Careers and Enterprise programme, working with schools and colleges across the whole patch to develop stronger links with employers. As it's about the receipt of money, John will talk us through this, but I'll also, I think, ask Mark Bassnett, who's here on behalf of the Growth Company.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. There's very little I need to say beyond that. It's one of the features of the Combined Authority acting as a accountable body for the Growth Company. I can leave it there and pass to Mark.
Okay, Mark.
Thanks, Metro Mayor. John, just to say that this award is built on the back of great work by colleagues at the Growth Company, but also in 134 schools right across all six boroughs that participate, the heads and career heads that give their time to this, the businesses that volunteer their time to help this, and obviously the students that participate. It's all about raising their aspirations and understanding about our city region and what understanding from the Careers and Enterprise Company that what's done in Liverpool City Region is exemplar for the rest of the country, and they're committed to supporting this funding, but also they've said to us there's more funding available if we continue this great work. So I'm very pleased to support it. Thank you.
I look forward to the next round. The recommendations are on page 359. Can anybody agree? Okay, we're just waiting because it's public question time on page 18. We're going to see if the questioner is in the building, and if so, the questioner can put the question to the committee. No. Okay, so the questioner isn't here, but we do have one question from Ellie Smith from the Vauxhall Law Centre, and she has asked if she's not here, could we read out her question? So, Jill, do you want to do that?
Thank you, Metro Mayor. In full, the statement and question from Ms Smith is congratulations to the Metro Mayor and the City Region offices for securing vital funding to provide much needed additional resources for advice provision during the cost of living crisis. Can the Metro Mayor confirm whether the resources secured will be shared out amongst other organisations such as law centres who also work in the advice sector?
It leads on from what we were talking about before, doesn't it, really, that the cost of living crisis has hit ordinary families right the way across the city region exceptionally hard, and many of the safety nets that people did rely on have been stripped away by 12 years of austerity. Our local authorities can't do what they used to do with less than half the money. And our leaders locally are doing everything that they can do to protect the most vulnerable. And it's some phenomenal work. Today, you've seen that we've approved the allocation of UK SPF, which is the replacement in part for European structural funds. But as I said earlier, the Conservative Party manifesto did promise that no one would be worse off, and we are by nearly, well, over a third, isn't it? It's over a third of our funding that's been cut. So in spite of that, collectively, we've chosen to prioritise those measures we think will support local people during the really difficult winter, and we're determined to make our funding stretch as far as we possibly can. That's what we always do, we get a bigger bang for our buck. Under the £2 million cost of living plans, the Land Authority will partner with CAB, as we know, and the Women's Organisation to build on the existing work that they're doing on financial resilience, so giving people the advice that they need on support as well, and advice on any other issues around that. And we recognise the fantastic work that our law centres, such as Vauxhall and others, are doing. To give people invaluable support and guidance all year round, and we will of course consider the role that these organisations could play in any future interventions or expansions of the existing programme. And we should note that wherever we do that, we look for enhanced delivery partnerships, and a clear call will be put out following what the Women's Organisation and CAB are doing. So, work with the Women's Organisation, we're happy to pick up a conversation with law centres on this, but what we'll do, we'll provide a written response to Ellie within 14 working days, and then hopefully as this develops, the law centres can get more actively involved. But we'll leave it at that. Is that okay?
Everyone?
Yeah, okay, then both 19 then is petitions and statements. And we haven't had any, so we'll go on to minutes, which are items 20 to 21. 20 is the scrutiny committee on the 13th, opening scrutiny on the 13th of July. Their minutes are on page 361 to 372. Can they be agreed? 21 is, can we note and agree the minutes of the Audit and Governance Committee, which is on the 30th of March 2022. They're on pages 373 to 382. And finally, can we note and agree the minutes of the Audit and Governance Committee on the 27th of July 2022? They're on pages 383 to 396. If they're all agreed, then thanks. thanks for your contributions and for your attendance today. And that concludes the meeting. The next LCR Combined Authority meeting will be held on Friday, the 18th of November 2022.